IVM.
कृपया ध्यान दीजिए, the language used on the podcast may not be fit for consumption. We warn you, tread carefully. But listen, yaar, don't be so conservative. Yes, the show is called Cyrus Says, because the person who's on the show is Cyrus. Also with me, a very interesting young man with a big future. We'll talk to him in a minute. But first, my words of wisdom. After that, there's nothing. This is basically the earbud I have used to create a new pathway. I have solved the problem of congestion in the nose. Now, let me explain. I took the vaccine 2 weeks back and had a little bit of cold and cough. I use this technique which I've devised, and I'm telling you, it is not WADA approved, or FDA rather approved. So please don't try it at home. But shoving the earbud into my nostril and then causing a sneeze to happen, violent sneeze, is the way to bring the phlegm out. This is a technique I just started on my own by, you know, accident, and I was successful. I destroyed the cold by using the earbud for the nose, so it becomes hence a nose bud. Now remember, this is my gift to you. You may or may not try it, but don't blame me if your nostril is too small, or the bud is too big, or you were too energetic, or you know, you suddenly were on a treadmill when you were doing it, and so hence you tore into your nose. These things are not my responsibility. I'm just telling you what I did. It's under patent at the moment. I'm trying to get it cleared. If things go well, then wow, this will change the world. This will be the next big thing after the computer. The nose bud for the nose instead of the earbud. But it's still the earbud, but it's used for the nose, if you get what I'm saying.
From uncensored and unfiltered chats with the who's who of the entertainment industry, I, Siddharth Kannan, bring you a very heartfelt chat show called Candid Kannan. Tune in every Friday on the IVM podcast app or wherever you get your podcasts.
With that being the beginning of our horrible show, today the show is saved by a young man, a very good-looking, sweet man, who I met in 1994 or 5, I'm not sure, for the first time. Kayozi Irani is here with us, actor, director, artist, head of production in 20 different companies. But also, Kayozi, just remind me first, how old were you when your dad was doing a play, I think, with us, and I first saw you?
In 94, when we met, I was 6.
6 years old. He was a little bacha. I held him in my hands, threw him up and down like a little puppy, and then I passed him to the next person, my friend Kunal, who dropped him because he's
he never held me. Cyrus never held me. He just said, no.
Take him away. Kayozi, how can you say that? You all were so cute, both the kids. And what people don't know, because of the association with your famous father, Mr. Bumman, not Bowman, if I hear anyone say Bumman or Farooq, please, it's Farooq and Bumman. There's no Bowman. We don't say Harrikishek, Harrishikesh, Harritik. Do we say that? No. We conform. We say Rishi, who's the engineer here. He spells it with an H. With an H. Have I ever called you Harrishi? He's on mute, so he can't answer. I'll answer for him. No, I haven't. All right. So please, it's Bumman. There's an O there. If he chooses to use O or A, that's his problem. But it's pronounced Bumman. And it's not Farooq. It's Farooq, if you talk to Parsis. So that's the lesson for the day. Kayozi, please, let's concentrate on this show, yaar. Kayozi now goes by the title Kayozi Bhai Zindabad, from that 6-year-old boy. Well, people don't, this is a true fact. Let me share, because they won't believe me. I talk rubbish all the time. But the true fact is, before your father's ascension to the throne and becoming this legendary actor, there was an association between you and India's greatest performer, Bana, Amitabh Bachchan.
Yes.
You were the first, correlation or co-actor with him.
Yeah, that's how I introduced Bumman.
You introduced Bumman.
Yeah,
and this, people don't understand this. So let me just quickly remind them. I don't know if you can, but Silvery, since you're listening, if at some point you can play Eer Beer Phatte, which is a famous, what do you call it, a video?
Music video.
Music video. It's a music video, but music, it's video. Basically a UP iconic sort of ballad, which he redid as he remade his career. Amitabh, I'm talking about. And in that, the star, I think there are 2 or 3 kids there, and very prominent is the young Kayozi. I wish we can show it to you before this show ends, at least for a second or two.
Please, if you show that show, everyone's going to turn around and say, oh God, what happened to him?
No, come on, because it's so nice. You have so many different things happened to you in your life. You know, I mean, come on, when you look back, you know, it's very cute. The fact of the
everyone matter, who sees my childhood photo says, you were so cute. What happened?
That's with everyone, Baba. That's, I mean, my case, not even you were so
cute. You are getting cuter, Cyrus, with your new white beard.
That's a thank, courtesy Uddhav Thackeray and his lockdown, which I don't approve.
You don't approve.
So I'm just stuck. I don't approve. I absolutely don't approve. And I will continue fighting as a lone voice blowing in the wind. No metaphor or pun there that, you know, this lockdown makes no sense. Anyway, let's get back to the great story of Kalyan. We'll start at the end now. Not the end, where we are right now, which is I have a bone to pick because it's called Ajeeb Dastans.
Yeah.
Now, my Hindi being very accurate and very good, I don't think Dastans is a word. Is it?
There's an extra A.
And there's extra S. What is Dastans? It's Dastan.
Dastan. There's more than one Dastan. It's plural.
That's in English. In Hindi, it doesn't become Dastans. What the hell are you doing?
Cyrus, that's why we cater to such a large audience. We cater to the Hindi audience. We cater to you, which is the South Mumbai audience.
So you made up a word. Just be honest and tell me the truth. They've made up a word. I just want to point that out. So don't come after me when my Hindi falters and I say wrong things. Okay, Kayozi, listen, enough of stupid jokes from both our sides. Let's get into it. We'll start where we are right now. This is your first proper big directorial. Let me just introduce it. It's on Netflix. It's called, as we just discussed, Ajeeb Dastans. And it's basically four directors doing 25-minute films.
Yeah.
Shashank Khaitan is one, Raj Mehta, Neeraj Ghaiwan is third.
Ghaiwan.
But above all, the best of the lot by far, and with no disrespect to these three, who I don't even know and probably will not talk to me ever again, Kayozi. Kayozi Irani with his fabulous story, which is called?
Ankahi.
Ankahi. Again, this is not a right word.
This is a right word on me.
I'm Googling it right now. Is this the right word?
Ankahi is unsaid.
Ankahi?
Ankahi.
But kahi, it sounds, are you sure?
See, Cyrus, I am a Parsi, so I don't think my Hindi is to be taken as
no, but you have a writer on board and all. Come on, you've got a big team.
I'm so somebody,
are these made up words or not? Just tell me that because now I'm getting really fuzzy. It's like keeping up with my daughter's lingo and all on the internet and on the chats. Can't understand. So, Ankahi.
We admitted every word in the film is a made up word.
Okay, enough of that. Let's move right to the whole story. So first, Kayozi, tell us how this came about, what your bit, your story exactly is all about. You talk now. I'll keep quiet.
The big question is, have you seen it?
See, I'll tell you. Let's get this elephant out of the room as fast as possible. On Friday of last week, Kunal Vijaykar, while pulling at his shirt, our common friend, they say, some say your role model, but I think you've eclipsed him. So he's now he follows you.
Mentor.
Yeah, exactly.
And I, his protege.
That protege is gone. Now you've gone ahead. But the thing is that you told him that make sure Cyrus sees it.
Huh.
And I was going to see it, but two things happened. One is, and honestly, this is true. My dad's attendant's mother passed away. So we spent the whole night trying to get him a ticket and then the test for whatever. And, you know, so all the logistics of that. Huh. And the second and more important thing, as a professional anchor, arguably the best since Karan Johar, who you vaguely work with, I don't think it's right for me to see and then talk. Because then it's like a retrospective. I would like to discover with you and then see, as will the audience who's listening.
Exactly my point. See, you didn't have to mention if you've not seen it. You had to mention if you've seen it because that would have been the news.
Correct.
That you've seen it.
Correct.
So I'll tell you about my film. What are your questions? How it came about?
No, you now, this is your bit now. You tell us about the whole thing, whatever you want to say, so we understand what the show is.
I've been working in the ad film and film industry now for about 12 odd years.
Mm.
And I've been with Dharma Productions, I think, for 8 or 9 of them.
We'll come back to all that. I just want to start here exactly with this creative.
So,
whose idea is it, etc.?
The thought of the film came from me. I like one basic thought in the film. And I approached the writers and they basically wrote everything. So if you didn't like it, I would blame the writers. And if you like the thought of it, you can thank me. That's it.
Come on, I'm sure it'll be fantastic, Kayozi. And listen, we are big supporters of Irani family. And I'm slightly, you know...
We have to only say good things.
Yeah, and also the community card and all that. After all, there are only 2,000 left. So we have to protect each other.
Yeah.
So there's no question, good or bad, there's no question. I'm all for nepotism. Not that this applies here. So are these love stories?
Mine is a love story. There is a thought of love. Every story is kind of different. So there's a thought of love in most of them. Some have a thought of revenge. Some have a coming of age. Some have dealing with the class system and all of that. I went for the love story in South Bombay. That was my film.
Oh, is it based on reality?
I wish. Maybe, because it doesn't really end well, the film. So, you never know.
Don't tell me all that, Baba. I hate endings which aren't good.
Then it should have been a retrospective, no, Cyrus?
Damn you, man. Always pointing out my faults. How mean. Anyway, what is the idea of doing this? Is it just the audience? I don't know. I now can't sit through 3-hour films. So I'm just thinking, is it a...
Oh, I love short films.
So do I. I just feel that...
I love this anthology way of watching it. Because I feel there's so many stories that need to be told in a smaller amount of time. And two is, as a filmmaker, you get so much more creative freedom to do what you want. And you're not stuck with the tropes of the box office and whatnot. And here it's just, oh yeah, sure, do whatever you want. So I love the idea of a short story.
But would you say that the audience, the world audience, is a little bit more primed now for short and sweet? It's just the way it is. A lot of fast forwarding happening when you watch a web series. A lot of, you know...
I don't know. I think it depends on how people's moods are. Like today, how your mood is, and today you're stuck at home and there's a lockdown and all, and you don't want to deal with too much. So you just say, I want to watch something simple and fast. So you watch it. But some people really want to get into it, and you can watch 6 seasons of Game of Thrones in 2 days. So I don't think that is the...
But no, I have scientific research to back my data.
Okay, let's hear it.
And by research, I mean sample study of one, Kunal Vijaykar. Because whenever he watches a web series and I question him about it, he seems to not remember any scenes.
Because I have slept next to Kunal Vijaykar while he watches...
Oh my God. And let me clarify.
Yeah.
Yeah, go on.
I've been on many holidays with him while he watches the web series, and he lies down looking at it like that, and I'm watching it. And through the most important part of it, I just hear... What happened? I said she died. Oh, okay, moving on.
So see, you've done it subconsciously at least for people like Kunal. You've realized that 25 minutes is as much as they can take. So let's just stick in a certain time frame so these guys can get something out of it.
I just hope he didn't sleep through the 25 minutes of my film, but that much if he stayed away would have been nice.
By the way, Aisha, my wife, is screaming, leave Kunal alone. She's become very protective. I can't make any jokes. Any disparaging comment, and she's like, no,
Kunal likes to believe that food brings people together. I think making fun of Kunal brings many people together.
At least in our little subculture, 100%. My God, yeah, you and your brother Danny. My God, I just look at y'all and we start making fun of him. I don't know how that happens. It's like a catalyst of sorts. Okay, listen. So that's the show. Now let's go back now into Kayozi's life.
Okay.
First and foremost, back in the day, you did that video.
Yeah.
So there was the acting chops were sort of already younger than any other Irani in the entire history of the family.
I stole the show.
You stole the show. Yeah. And then you also, let's just move on then. So what was your, as you became an adult, what was your plan?
The minute I left college, I did a small stint as an intern with Raju Hirani on Three Idiots. It was a very small stint in the pre-production of Three Idiots. After which I left and finished my college in KC College. And then I joined Ram Madhavani. And I did a lot of ad films with him as an intern. And you know Ram, I'm guessing, Cyrus.
Yeah, yeah. I've interviewed Ram on this show. I've also done maybe three ads with Ram. Two for sure, maybe three. When I was much younger, of course. And they were both lovely and painful. Painful because it takes a long time to shoot and wants to talk about everything.
You want to be out in 2 hours.
I know you want to be out. I'm not a big fan of pre-production. I like to get on with it. I'm very good at doing things. You know, I'm a doer, despite what people think. But when you come on the set and you keep chatting, then you lose me after some time. But having said that, I mean, who can argue with Ram's body of work?
No, he's a lovely man. Ram has been my mentor for many, many years. So I'm
Did he invent the 360-degree shot or something for an Adidas ad? Or,
yes, the Sachin ad.
Sachin ad. So a lot of iconic moments and all
that. He's brilliant. So I did a lot of work with Ram.
How was your temperament with his?
Sorry?
How was your temperament? You know, long hours and being very finicky and double-checking and scratch films and all that.
Working with him, I go like, oh God, what is this? And the minute I'm done working with him, I appreciate him. Because then I know that when I go into the real outside world, it's so much easier. So I love Ram and what all he's taught me. And genuinely, his systems and way of working and his methodology and all of that.
We're just making it up. Like in Hindi, even in English, just we wing it, we make it, we swing it. That's it. Good enough for me.
And so I'm working with Ram right now as well. I love working with him. Whenever I get the chance, no matter what, I'll go in and assist him because it's like a refresher's course.
Okay, here's my question to you. A lot of people but 10 people who watch it will probably want to know, everybody spends a lot of time, and I'm not against academics and formal training and all that, it's fine. Academics and formal training, my wife, the critic, my God. But my question to you is, you actually learned everything on the job.
Yeah.
And I think in our line, maybe that's more important than the formal training after a point, because you're sitting there and whether it's pre-production asking you to get things or post-production trying to finish off edits and things like that or the actual shoot.
Right now, only Ajib Dastans has done well. We don't know if the next film will do well or not. So we don't know whether working on the job helps. I learned everything on the job. And I had an opportunity to go to USC in LA to study filmmaking. It was a 3-year very expensive course. And we just had a decision. I said, no, you know what? I'll just start right at the bottom. And whether it be sweeping the floors of a set or whatnot, I'll learn it on the job. And I do believe that experience somewhere matters a lot. I feel that if I went abroad, I should have stayed abroad because the learning is for that, while we follow a different sort of learning. Then not to take away from learning, because I learned a lot in the classroom as well, but I just did a mass media course. But it took me longer. It took me longer to be a director than it would otherwise.
Yeah, and also the pressure of making the film, you can't duplicate that, can you, in the classroom, whatever people say.
No, that. But I don't think learning it from a school can duplicate it either. The pressure, no matter what you say, no matter how close you are to the film, and you have directed a film, and 2 days before the release, not knowing how people are going to react, there's nothing you can do. Oh God, those butterflies are like crazy.
So, Kayo, what are you going to say to young guys who probably will, you know, ask you if they get an opportunity? Middle-class people who perhaps are not very comfortable spending the kind of money you have to spend for these courses, the media courses, etc. And is it? And again, I'm not rubbishing the courses. I'm just asking you, is it worth their while or not? Or should they try and do what you did?
I would say, of course, it's worth their while. But if it's not feasible to take a course, one is that don't just do any course. Do a good course. And if it's not, then I'd rather you work. But while working doesn't mean that I just go to the set, I do my job and I come back. You have to do 10 times more than what you're asked for. And then when you come home, you sit and you watch every single kind of movie you can. Every old movie. Please, any student has to like watch a movie, then watch it again with director commentary, then study it, then read what people have to say, and even watch bad movies. There's so much to learn in bad movies. So that is what I didn't let myself stop at. And I have to give credit to my father for that. Where he would always say, watch this movie. I said, oh, it's sounding so boring, this movie. He said, no, watch this movie. You learn something. I said, I didn't like the movie. I said, but you learned to use this. I said, yeah, that's true. So if you're...
Now that you brought Baman into the conversation and the second elephant in the room, tell us a little bit about the fact of having such a famous father. Does it help or hinder? So I'm wondering if you're on Rajkumar Hirani's set, will you get special treatment because you're Kayozi Hirani and not just Kayozi Sharma?
I never get special treatment. I don't like to tell anyone that I'm my father's son. People, of course, discover it along the way. But I hate to tell anyone that because I don't want that treatment. I don't.
So if somebody asks you your mom and dad's name, you say Zenobia and, well, that other guy.
I say Mr. Singh.
I hope they don't hear this now. Huh? Then.
No.
No, but it's a smart thing to do, right? Because I think it's very difficult, especially in the industry, for people, now he's a senior figure, to not treat you differently.
I've seen people who, once they find out, treat me differently. And the minute that happens, I kind of take a step back, that treat me for who I am, you know, and I'm not...
Question, if you tell them you're Kunal Vijayakar's best friend, do you get any different treatment?
Yes, they throw me off the set.
How sad. Every 5 minutes, we have to take one shot at Kunal. That's by law. We can't continue otherwise. Okay. Anyway, coming back to the...
Having my dad at home, he has never told me what to do, and he's never told me how to do it. I've in fact gone to him many times and said, how do I do this? And he'll say, I'm not going to tell you. And I say, why? And he says, because if I tell you, that would be my way of doing it. You have to figure out your way of doing it. All I can do is that while you're going down your path, I'll nudge you a little bit back on the path so I know that you're being straight. And I'll just give you the moralities and the honesty of how to be on the set. Otherwise, why do you want to be Baman Irani? You have to be yourself. And he tells me that I don't want you to be known as Baman Irani's son. I want to be known as Kayozi Irani's father. So, yeah. He's not rather you think about it.
What about Kunal Vijayakar's friend? That's not ever come into the conversation.
Then he says, and he says that I want to be known. And Kunal Vijayakar, as much as you can, just award it.
Have you ever asked Kunal for help?
I have asked Kunal for a lot of help, actually.
And has it been a very long lecture or what?
You know what I'm thinking? But you know what? Why don't you come over around 12:30 and we can...
It's always a lunch appointment for any conversation. What's with that? Whenever you ask him anything about anything, even if someone died, it's like, let's discuss it over lunch.
Yeah, let's just come over lunch. And then the first one I is discussing, so should we do a biryani? Or should we, you know, like, should we just order something? But Kunal is my confidant. Much ever we make fun of him inside, I know you hate to admit, but you love him to death. And he's my confidant. I tell him everything. I tell him things about my personal life.
Yeah, I don't think we can discuss everything, but I do know that his house has been a shelter for the refugee Kayozi from time to time, which is good to have.
When my house was under renovation, I stayed at his house for 9 months.
Correct.
So yeah. He's my mentor and I'm his protege. And
whose habits are worse?
I think everyone thought that, you know, Kunal will get into some good habits with Kayo, but no, Kayo got into some bad habits with Kunal.
So one of them I know, which we will not discuss. I hope your family doesn't see it. Yeah. Speaking of family, let's talk a little bit about the family. It's quite a fabulous. I mean, I'm just looking back at how you guys were in Sofia in the dressing room in 1994. It's very nostalgic for me for a minute. These two young kids, and they were shy and quiet and so well behaved. Not to sound communal, as Parsi children generally are, brought up to, you know, mind their manners and not be, you know, loud and whatever. Of course, there are a few exceptions I won't name. But yeah, and then to see your progress from there, and then slowly getting into this entire business, and now, you know, being your own man and as a director, you've come up to a point where I think there's no looking back. So here's the big question we ask you.
Right.
Now you've tasted success, and people are talking about it. It's made a lot of buzz, a lot of noise already on Netflix and beyond. Where do you go from here? Are you going to stick with this genre? You think that as a filmmaker, you should have one oeuvre or whatever the right word is? Would you go for the feature? Will you have to get the big stars in? What's Kayozi going to do?
I'll tell you something, Siren. This is, I think, for all filmmakers. I don't think filmmakers care about genre or miniseries or short film feature or big stars or not. They care about what is the story they're going to tell and what is the best way they can tell it. And the minute a story comes to you and you say, wow, what I want to tell this story, whether it's a short film or a miniseries or on an OTT platform or in the theater, you will tell it. So for me personally, the next film that comes my way, the next story that comes my way, I'm okay for it to be on any sort of platform or in any sort of format. I'm just not very drawn to horror. Other than that, I'm open to anything.
Why not horror? I love horror.
I get very scared in horror films. You know, because all horror films are there.
But that's to watch.
I don't want to put the audience through what I go through.
Okay.
I want to enjoy my film as much as the audience enjoys the film. No.
Okay, two questions. I will have to rush into break. So two or three questions I'll try and fit in. One is, what happens to Irani Brothers production, which you guys had started? Are you going to do things from there? Or is it...
So, that is very much in full flow. Danny's handling the whole production side of it. Of course, the pandemic has not helped at all. And it's not easy. But it's not just for me. It's for everyone. In fact, my dad is planning to work, through Irani Movie Tournament.
Okay.
So that is completely in flow. But yeah, it's difficult in terms of the pandemic.
Okay. Can Kayozi give us the wish list of actors and actresses that he would like to work with in the near future? Top three?
Very keen to work with Vicky Kaushal. I would love to work with Alia. And all-time favorite for no reason whatsoever is to work with Shah Rukh Khan.
Yeah, everybody loves Shah Rukh. He's like Raymond. Nobody ever says
it. I just shot an ad with him right now. It was 2 days of just the best time I had.
What ad was it?
Hyundai.
He's been doing Hyundai. He must be owning Hyundai by now.
I think 20 years or so he's been.
Yeah, it's an unbelievable association. It's longer
than... He's the easiest, nicest, bestest person to work with. I love Shah Rukh.
Okay, before we go into break, we must get a Kayozi Kunal Vijayakar story for our listeners and viewers. This man has caused a lot of pain and angst in your life. Give us your favorite Kunal Vijayakar story.
But all his stories are so long.
That's okay.
My favorite Kunal Vijayakar story actually is when he went on a date once. He went on a date with this... It was a very, very pretty girl. And... And they went to
Aisha, me, Farah, and him. Her name was Farah.
Farah. They all went to Paradise.
Paradise.
And which is not a place you would take someone for a date. It's some place you go when, oh, I'm really craving some food. And I think and the night before the date, he amped up the keep gosh.
Yeah, and that's the whole reason we went there.
You must have the keep gosh. And it makes it like this and all. And this girl, I think she was also a foodie and she really enjoyed the idea of having the key. Okay, we'll go. And Paradise is not somewhere you go for a date, okay? Not in a million years. You're better off at McDonald's. And so they go to Paradise, they sit down and the waiter comes and he says, "Do kit go chalana." Okay, sir. And the waiter goes in and he comes back after 2 minutes and says, "Sir, sorry, ek hi kit go baki hai." Ooh. So what will you have?
Spot on. Absolutely true. Completely true. Unbelievable. I was me and Aisha were sitting opposite. We almost spat out our soup. It was like, what?
You know, my favorite thing about all Kunal stories.
Yeah.
And he doesn't realize it's funny until we tell him.
He has no idea about humor. I've been saying this from the beginning. He has no idea.
Of course. It's correct.
Oh, there's so many stories in that Kulaba area. I've got five that are coming out of my head. But we don't have time, and it's not about him. It's about Kayozi, the journey of a young man from a video where he outshone Amitabh Bachchan, no less. Irbir Patte, I hope we can see it after the break, to where he is now. He's not telling us what film is coming up next, but maybe we'll get it after the break. The Cred Mega Jackpot Week has got me way too excited. Kayozi, show an excited face, please. Thanks, man. From 3 years of free flights to winning a new Tata Safari car, you've just won the car. How do you feel?
But where do I go to drive? We're in lockdown.
That's true. There are tons of prizes to be won. You can even win free iPhones for the next 10 years. 10 years. By the way, my daughter's a huge iPhone fan, aren't you?
So am I.
Yeah, it costs too much money, bro. But thanks to this Cred ad that we've done, I don't have to spend that money again because 10 years of free iPhones. Cred Mega Jackpot Week is from 27th April to 3rd May. I ask you, from 27th April to?
3rd May.
Very good. New jackpots will be received every day and crazy offers from partner brands on specific days. So don't miss. Just download.
Cred.
Yes. Excellent. We did it together in the end. All right. We now welcome Silvery, who is not upcoming, he's very much established comedian in Powai.
Upcoming only. It's fine.
Charges 7 lakhs just to make an entrance. And then after that, you have to pay for every joke.
Yeah, yeah.
Silvery, say hi to Kayozi.
Hi, Silvery.
Hi, Kayozi. Good morning. Hi. Nice to meet you.
Have you seen Ajeeb Dastans?
No, I haven't. I'm so sorry. But meaning to watch it for sure. 100% meaning to watch it.
Wow.
Not even lying.
No guest will come on our show with this lazy attitude of producer and anchor.
What? Yeah, I know. Sorry,
really?
Sorry.
Kayozi, I'm going to watch it right now. Not right now.
I watch it, right? Why? Let's just watch it together on the show.
Let's watch it together.
So the second half can be just that?
Ladies
and gentlemen, Kayo Irani in concert. All right. So now, before we go to the AMAs, is there anything you want to ask the young man?
Me? No. I mean, you're putting me on the spot.
I haven't watched the film.
No, I thought you also interested in filmmaking and all this, the line that he's in. So I just thought maybe you could ask him.
Okay, I will ask you.
He's also worked a lot with Karan Johar. You can ask him anything about the experiences of actors. There's some big names you worked with, if I'm not wrong. Kayozi?
As an assistant, yeah.
As an assistant. And Kunal has told me times when you've had to rebuke. I won't take names because that's your call to take or not take. But you've rebuked fairly senior performers. Is this true?
Yeah.
Is it possible to tell one quick tale?
No, absolutely not.
No names. Just tell me the story.
I've especially on ad films, I've lost it many times with the client, who you know, usually we treat the client very nicely, and I am a first AD on set, and if we do the shot, I always say everyone okay, we're moving on, and we move the camera to the other side, and after 10 minutes, one client, you know, in that shot, we just felt, what do you think?
They always do that.
Can we do it? I said no, we are not doing this, and I've moved on, and too late.
You think your dad would do that?
My dad would not, but that's why Kunal Vijaykar is my mentor.
Yeah. That's a more Kunal thing than...
My father would say, you know what, we should go back and let's try for
me. He's never going to say no. He's always going to make the other guy happy. Yeah.
I have lost my head sometimes.
But one name?
Name? No, I...
Forget no, the clients. No, what about no, the actors you've... when they've argued or given you trouble?
Yeah, I have lost a couple of times with actors as well, but... Because when I'm told 8 hours, but then the actor's taken 4 hours to get ready and 1 hour to gym and all, but I said, really? Oh, that's counted. You know what? Let's just not stop shooting. I said, I'm okay to stop shooting.
So in the 8 hours, in the 8 hours, he told you I need 4 hours for getting ready and going to the gym in the 8 hour shift.
He or she took 4 hours out of the 8 hours to get ready.
Wow.
And when they came on set, I said, okay. I said, listen, we're not going to finish in the next 4 hours. No, sorry, I only have 4 hours. I said, you know what? We're not going to finish. So there's no point in even trying to make half an hour. Let's stop it here and let's just go home.
And then what happened?
Then of course they stay. Oh.
But at the end of the day, everybody's friends or somebody hold it against you? Because these are big egos, I presume.
I don't think anyone's... I'm friends with everyone. I don't think anyone's held it against you. I say it... I like to say it with a little bit of a comic twist. That is my addition to what Kunal does. Kunal just throws
something. So you're Kunal with charm. That's a totally different Kunal. Come on, for God's sake. Really. All right.
I feel it's a bit of a comic twist, but yeah.
Fair enough. Yeah, but you know, you've got your own path, your own way. I think it's the right thing to do. And at the end of the day, you've got to make the film, right? The bugger doesn't give you time. How are you going to do it?
Exactly. It's my problem to make the film.
Exactly. I pretend to smoke, which is against all principles. Do not do it at home. Sorry.
I mean, are you smoking the earbud. Same bud you put in your
yes,
nose?
Yes, yes.
There
yes,
you go. It's the same bud.
Oh, wow. Also, when you kept saying nose bud, I kept thinking of the Citizen Kane movie. When he says no, rosebud as the last
rosebud.
Thing he ever says.
Yeah, yeah. No.
Nosebud.
I'll clarify everything to you. Good to know you've seen Citizen Kane, though. I'm quite impressed.
Oh, no, I haven't. But I saw Mank recently. I saw Mank. The
you
Oscar
saw the reference. You saw the reference. Okay,
yeah, all right.
Good enough. Yeah. Yossi's gone convulsing now.
I've got a vein popping here.
Yeah, we can't see anything.
Okay, chalo.
Have you done makeup for this?
Are you crazy?
Spruced up and cleaned and all.
I just used soap on my face. And I gave myself a haircut though.
You gave yourself a haircut? Achha, you shaved that.
Through the pandemic, I gave myself a haircut. I just take the razor and go wing like this.
Can you cut the top and the back and all that?
Little bit. I just chung. From the back, it's.
What the hell? You've got Danny sitting in the bloody house with you. Your brother.
No, I don't have Danny sitting in the house. I live in another house.
But you go there. One of them can help you.
Yeah, but then I.
Do you know
I
who can cut your hair? My mom cut my hair twice.
I don't trust Danny's hair cutting skills.
That's a bit.
I've not done makeup. Sorry. I just opened the window so the light is slightly better, even though it's overexposed.
Oh, what a show off! Silvery, what the hell, man? It has a lesson in bloody lighting now. Yeah. Okay, Gauzi, don't mind if we take a 2 to 6 second break.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to another great week on the IVM Podcast Network. If you're not following us on social media, please do. We're IVM Podcast on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. We'd like to thank the sponsors on the network this week, thewholetruthfoods.com, Seattle, PayPal, and Cred. We thank you all for your support. Tune into The Note, where Maru Kanaya talks to Dr. Bipin Joshi about the second wave of COVID. He calls it no less than World War III. On The Habit Coach, Ashton was joined by Yoshita Dave, who's a sex educator and intimacy coach. On Paisa Vaisa, Anupam Gupta was joined by Amit Thakkar and Hiral Jain of Market Pulse Technologies, and they talked about trading in Indian markets. All Things Policy by the Takshashila Institute had on board Mihir Mahajan and Pranay Kothasthane to talk about the recent changes in the Indian intellectual property front. You should definitely check out the Cyrus Says episode with Ace Casting Director Mukesh Chabra. They discussed some of his best work. We also had Ira Mukoti, who has authored various books on history and mythology from a female gaze. The IPL season is in full swing and we have Edges and Sledges in English and Khel Niti in Hindi if you want to check out cricket content. Really, really great conversations on both of those shows. Do check those out. And with that, let's get you back to your show.
Follow me at Instagram and Twitter on Bored Brocha. I'm so bored, I need your help. I need your love. I need your touch. Okay, just follow me. Okay, come on, let's get on with it.
Let's get into the AMAs. The first one comes in from Kashin Shetty. Again, Kashin, hi, how are you?
Kashin is a big star on our show and he's also a very famous guy.
Huh? Yeah, he says, since you're both Parsis who were raised in different eras, what's the one pro and con of growing up in your respective decades? Also, is the Parsi dairy farm really that great?
Kajal, you want to take the second question first?
Second question first. The Parsi dairy farm, Malai Kulfi, is fantastic.
Gulab Jamun is quite famous also.
I like the Malai Kulfi.
I also like the Malai Kulfi. It's iconic. I'm sorry. I take it back. You're right. So, if you think, that's the first thing you think of. Fair enough. Absolutely. Yeah. They used to have a very good yogurt back in the day when I was a young man and there was no yogurt culture like y'all have today. And they had small curd, which was called, not called yogurt, it was called sweet curd or whatever, but it's yogurt basically. In flavors, very tasty. That's in the 90s I'm talking about.
Now, I don't think it's there, but I like the Malai Kulfi. And I don't like sweets at all. I don't like anything meetha.
Silvery, you like Malai Kulfi?
Yeah, I love Malai
Kulfi. As a concept at least?
Yeah. I like Malai Kulfi.
There you go. Talking about different eras, I think the one thing I remember with sitting in MTV days with Shanaz and all after a show, and I realized one thing is there. Like, for example, we all grew up on the similar kind of music, whatever era. You know, so if we start singing certain songs, so Shanaz and I were just singing and nobody else could sing with us. You know, we were singing songs like Lily and, without the F word, Alice and those kind of songs. They're just songs that would just, trigger off one after another. And most of the others would not know. So there's a little subcultural musical thing which is there for sure. Right from classical music all the way down to all the folk songs, country songs. You'll find that in almost all households across eras. So I'm sure Kayozi although he doesn't like to sing that much in public for some reason, probably be able to sing along.
No, but I completely agree with you, because my song taste is similar to my father's Parsi song taste. I like the old school. I sit and listen to Frank Sinatra all the time.
There you go.
So yeah.
Frank Sinatra was Parsi.
I think Parsis have got an era and they've stuck to it.
That's true. I also think that little bonding happens even if you meet younger ones or older ones or whatever, because the musical tastes are more or less the same and they're there forever. Of course, then they'll have their music of their era, which they will also know because they grew up in an era, but they will always know the songs from the past. That I know.
Yeah.
That's a given. But Silver, you're also not bad. You know your Beatles songs and all, so you have a bit of that. You probably... Is that not true?
Yeah, I love the Beatles.
And the other thing that we share is a love for erotic literature.
True.
That's also there. We all have... We're a few people who have hard copies and all till today, you know, what you call paper copies and all that. I mean, our good friend Kunal Vijaykar, who's more Parsi than I am, he used to have a collection of some 40, 50 books, and he's not a reader. His only literature was Human Digest. Oh, the stories I could tell you, boys. The stories I could tell you. But Aisha, it's all true. I'm not lying. The man was consumed with love for erotic literature. And what is wrong with that? He's not harmed anyone. He would sit alone in his beach candy flat in the dark and get on with it. It's not a show about Kunal. It's about Kayozi. But this happens as a residual effect. I'm sorry if you're listening. My wife is talking in the background. You can't hear her, which makes you twice as lucky as... Right. let's get on.
Is Kunal listening to the show right now?
He is. Apparently. He is. Or he said he would be, because he's the one who gave me all the information. He's the Irani PA. If you want to know anything about Irani family, you ask him. He'll tell you exactly. Like where Danny is crossing the road or at what point, and he's just fabulous. You've elevated him in my eyes because he's never shown interest in anybody, huh?
Okay.
AMAist.
All right, yeah. Next one comes from the plant-based foodie.
What is AMA?
Ask me anything, or in Tamil, it's Amma.
Okay, take it.
Yeah. Bolo.
All right. This one comes from the plant-based foodie. That's the name of the person.
Plant-based foodie.
That can't be our boy.
Kunal's tuning off right now.
Yeah. It's like a paradox. Anything else would have... There is a chance. But this is like the complete opposite. Antonym. Huh.
Okay. This person asked, why do you think movies tend to show an unreal version of an Indian marriage? Keeping up with the brochas would be the ultimate in realism and effective premarital counseling. Your thoughts, Kayo?
He said it's a compliment. He's saying that ours is a real marriage. And Kayo, to your industry... bit of a non-compliment, I think it's more TV than film, because TV has been very retrograde when it comes to showing marriages and the way the conversations are between husband and wife.
I'll tell you what I think. Okay. And I think that in India especially, films are treated with as much love as cricket, and people are obsessed with it. And the reason is it sort of forms an escapism for people, and it's not just going to the cinema and just seeing a film. There is a culture of song and dance and celebration. When you have a song, I think we stop the screenplay and we have a celebration. And that forms an escapism for the audience. For whatever they're going through at that current time in their lives, whether it be problems at home, problems at work, and all of that. Personally, for me, when it comes to family and a marriage, I have grown up seeing my parents who have and Cyrus can back me up on this, I think the most unbelievable marriage, and I keep telling them it's impossible to match up to this, because they are
impossible.
They are buddies. They never fight ever. If there is a fight, it's about my father who's eaten an egg.
Minor things.
Like he's not taken his medicine or something like that. They are like, it's like a ridiculously...
There's an alignment which is not actually... Kayoji, like you said in the beginning, that's not a real example almost. It's against the norm. I see marriages around me and my own. That is a very rare, nice space, frankly.
Yeah, it's scary. So that's...
Maybe the medication he's taking is very good. I don't know.
So that's what I really feel.
No, but that's fair enough from your personal life. But I'm asking you, because this guy's point is that we have for years just made a very fake idea of what a marriage partnership is, in terms of the sexism that's displayed, in terms of the clothes they're wearing, in terms of the conversation. It's never close to any reality. So when the guy is saying keeping up with the brochures, it's a very bad example, but that's closer to a reality is what he's saying. There's no reality.
That's what I said initially, is that I feel that for us, films is an escape. It's an escape from our reality. I feel that in many times Indian audiences do not want to.
But shouldn't we also have the reality?
But I think so many films have reality.
What would Kayozi make?
Watch films like Kapoor and Sons.
Yeah, that's true.
So there's so many films have reality, but that's a different kind of audience enjoys that.
And what would you make? What would Kayozi like to make? Do you think like that? Do you think that I have to be more true and real, or do you not think like
yeah,
that?
Yeah, I do. I do. I that is how I think. But that doesn't mean that every audience member is going to like my film. In India, we don't have one language. We don't have one thought. We are so...
So what you're saying is the market is not one homogeneous market.
No.
Correct me if I'm wrong. What you're saying is that, you know, there are some people who want escapism. They want to get away from their own marriage, yeah, maybe, and see a happy marriage. And then those who say, what the hell is this crap? It's too medieval for me. I want a dose of natural real life.
It's fit for an action film. It's like if you see the big-ass action films with the unrealistic stunts. But that is so for some people enjoy that. And today, especially nowadays, I feel more and more films are getting realistic. But that is for a different audience altogether.
What you're saying, no judgment. Different strokes for different folks. All cinema
exactly,
is good.
Exactly. Exactly.
Or bad. Yeah. Now you brought it up again. I have to ask you, does Kunal Vijayakar do his own stunts?
I just saw him doing a stunt right now in this Hello Charlie film. I don't know if you saw it.
He's got a role in that.
He ran so well.
He ran?
He ran. You've not seen in the opening three or four scenes of Hello Charlie.
He's prostituted himself. He's run only for money.
Through the fort area where your office is.
Through the fort area?
He's run like this. And he's kept up with a fit.
Was it closing time at Trishna? Because that has happened once. Hello, 2:55. Bhago. 3 o'clock closing.
Yeah, so please see. I swear I saw it twice.
Can you send the link? Is there a link available?
It's on Amazon. It's on Amazon.
Okay. Amazon.
Hello, Charlie. It's in the third or fourth scene. He runs.
Wow.
And I swear, I thought it was VFX.
I just hope he was. Hope he was wearing underwear. Oops. Ouch. All right. Next one, young man, Silvery.
Yep. One thing though, can I say I've worked with your brother, Danish. I've AD'd for a play he was starring in called Knock Knock Who's There, Ace Productions.
No, that's not Danish. That's another Danish.
Oh, that's not my brother.
That's Silly Point Danish.
That's not Danish Hirani?
That's another Danish Hirani.
Even Parsis have the same names, you know?
Okay.
It happens sometimes.
But we have fewer names.
Okay. But they're all from the same school, if I'm not mistaken. They're all Marians.
Danish, yeah.
All a few them. Years apart. Yeah. So, including Baman and Kunal. So, all Marians we've discussed. If there's any St. Marians listening, this is the time for you to ask questions. Yeah.
All right. All right. Next one comes in from Trishla Shah. She asks, how was it working with Shefali Shah and Manav Kaul on Ankahi?
Back to the movie.
I don't think it could have been any better. And I don't think it could have been any easier. Because genuinely, and I mean this when I say it, I didn't really have to direct them. We never did a rehearsal, ever. And they just did it from the first take. And I would just go and say one thing here and one thing there. But when you have actors like that, I mean, what more can you ask for? So,
but how do you establish the dynamic between, as you're a young guy,
yeah,
and sometimes they're very big names, Shefali Shah is known, et cetera, so is Manav Kaul. How, when you first meet them, who's the alpha? I mean, is there that play happens or not?
No, strangely, no. Because I think both are very nervous because they do sign language in the film. They have a lot of their dialogues were in sign language. So they were nervous in terms of learning a new language, like a foreign language film. So, I had studied it a little bit. So, but they were amazing with me. I really, first I thought, you know, like, who the hell am I? This Parsi boy who's only interested in what's for lunch. And I've acted in something before. Who's going to take me seriously? But they were like amazing. And we were really, really having a happy time on set. We would just laugh and joke, even in the sad scenes.
I got a little secret about Manav Kaul, who's your star here. Yeah. I think it was him. I'm trying to remember clearly, but about 7-8 years ago, when my son was hardly 10 or 11, Shailendra Singh had a benefit match for somebody or something in the club, in the gym, Bombay gym. And my son played alongside me and he bowled leg breaks. At that time, he was very into cricket. And second ball, Mr. Kaul tried to lift him over mid-wicket and was caught by young Rishi Pense, a rugby star. So just got out to a 10-year-old. In your face, Mr. Kaul.
Mr. Kaul right now has, I think, become the heartthrob of the nation.
But maybe.
Because apparently he's looking great in the film and he's become a lover boy. And
so does he share the spoils with the director or?
That's why I'm not working with him.
It's a little more Ajeeb, the Dastan here.
That's the reason I'm not working with him again. That's it. That's it. He can't take all the attention.
Did you shout at them and all? Not them, but in life, do you lose your temper on a scene?
I'm a different director than I'm an AD.
Okay, so as an AD, you're a bit of a bully.
I'm an AD.
But as a director, you're more bummer.
I have more to lose as a director.
I was just wondering, you have to work with different personalities. There's a lot of man management and psychology also involved, which is beyond the creative.
No, I didn't need to. I genuinely didn't need to. I got no trouble. My worry is now, how do I go from here? It was so easy. Now, what do I do?
You work. I'll give you two actors you work with and you will find trouble. Cyrus Broch and Kunal Vijaykar. Your life will change. What do they do that? Do that as a test for yourself. Okay. Silvery, next.
Yeah, all right. So, turns out my mother is in the chat and she has written, I love the story by Kayoze. It was very sensitively directed. Congratulations, wow. Kayoze. Shefali and Man of Call both were excellent.
There you go.
So, my mother is making up for me not having watched this. Sorry,
Kayoze. Thank your mother very, very much. Thank you so much, ma'am. And not to you and Cyrus, yes, who have not seen the film. Really, really well prepared for the interview. Cyrus, yeah. I watched podcasts of yours to prepare for this interview. You didn't watch my film.
See, I'll tell you. I learned from Gary Sobers. I'm not saying I'm Gary Sobers or Ian Botham, okay? Who didn't practice at all. They drank themselves silly and Botham even walked into a Brisbane test match without the bat onto the pitch. They forgot it. So, you know, let it be now. People have different ways. As long as you're calm and relaxed. I will watch it. I promise you, I will. Just like I said, we had a few things happening last night when I was going to watch the film and things got out of control. I'm not lying about that. Because when I lie, my eye twitches and that's not happening. Now, sorry, just quickly, want to just tell you, ask you a question before he gets to the next one. So, there's a lot of success with Ajeeb Dastan and Na Kahi, Unkahi, the word which makes a lot of sense.
It is an actual word, Cyrus.
How is it an actual word?
It is an actual word. Unkahi is a word.
Is a word.
Unsaid. Yeah, Cyrus, unsaid.
Let's take it from the man who knows the language and not from the two of us who know the language.
He's a Punjabi boy. They murdered Hindi as badly as us. Don't worry about it. I'm going to fight this. I am going to fight this. Gopal Dutt, who is my actual Shuddh Hindi scholar, he's an actual academic and reads Hindi properly, Devanagari properly. I'll get everything from him.
But Ankai is a common enough word. I'm sure it's used in songs and all also.
Use it in an expletive, like MCBC.
It's not a word that goes with
these are phrases I understand. So use it in a sentence with MC or BC and I will understand.
Unkahi dekha kya? Madhur Chod. Sorry.
Your mom's on the chat. In your face. Mom's on the chat. Yes, we got him. Good. He forgot. Sorry, auntie. Sorry about that. Sorry, the boy will learn. Aaj butter chicken cancelled. Let's get right back into it. So I was asking you, so the success of this, and now this is the new world, all right? And your OTTs are deciding your life and career and all that. The buzz is very good. You're getting all. So then how do you, when people say nice things to you and all, do you feel validated for your effort? Because at the same time, if things don't go well, would it upset you?
I feel very awkward when people say nice things. I've gotten so many messages and calls and I don't know what to reply. I say, thank you so much. This is my standard. Thank you means, thank you for watching.
They will listen to this podcast.
Huh? No, but I write sometimes. I don't know what to say. I don't think too many people have seen this podcast. Don't worry.
Yeah. By insulting us, it doesn't get you off the hook. It takes one person to see it and get irritated with you. Yeah, no, but I'm also asking because if things don't go well, then you deal with that as well. People being critical.
Yeah, I mean, there have been criticisms as well. And it's good. You learn from it. So some of the criticisms I agree with.
So do you get anything from your dad on this one? As how to deal with people's feedback and...
I think dad on this film has really been a dad. He cried in the first 5 minutes of watching the film. So I said there was nothing to cry in the first 5 minutes. I understand you cried later, but I think this has been one dad and he's like been like so happy and proud. So in this instance, no, he's been like, don't worry about it. Just
and mom.
Although my mother told me, because I was not staying at home when the film released, I was in quarantine. So my mother told me, that when you come home, and it was about a weekend after and a lot of good reviews and success and whatnot. I said, when you come home, we have to talk. I said, okay, what happened? No, we come home and we talk and I have written down what I have to say to you because I have to fire you. I said, oh God. I said, what happened? No. All this success and people are saying nice things and all that. If you get arrogant, you will get one slap from me.
So nice.
She has decided to fire me.
But did she like the film?
Sorry?
Did she like the film?
She loved the film.
Kalji, if you're having problem with your throat now, just use this technique that I've devised. You take the earbud, you shove it in your nose, and you shove it till it gets that irritation and all the phlegm comes out.
Yeah,
Will you want me to send you this earbud?
God knows how long.
I'll send it to you. Kunal will probably come home today or tomorrow. I'll send it with him. Okay. It's yellow in color. You can.
It's only that earbud, is it?
Well, I only have one. So okay. I mean, because of lockdown, I don't feel like going and buying more.
Sorry.
Can we squeeze one more in, Mr. Silvery?
Yes, sure. Next one comes in from Rushil Nair. He asks, good morning all. Question to Kayoze. Which book would you love to make a film out of one day?
I love all of John Grisham's books.
But haven't they been made into films, most of them?
Yeah, many of them. Some have not. The Bleachers, for example. I love that.
Silvery, pretend you and I have read it. Haanji, that's a good one.
If a good book is there, it's most of the time already been made. But there's so many. I love any book that is a spy thriller or detective, or I'm obsessed with courtroom dramas. I want to find a book about a courtroom.
My cousin Vinny has already been made, no? Your dad was in it. Isn't it Jolly LLB vaguely?
What are you talking?
Wasn't it vaguely on My Cousin Vinny?
Which film?
My Cousin Vinny is
Jolly LLB.
No, Jolly LLB was not My Cousin Vinny.
Of course, it's a similar story, isn't it?
It was just a courtroom drama. It had some comedy in it, doesn't it?
Okay, so which one would you... have you seen And Justice for All, Al Pacino?
I've seen every single courtroom drama.
Which?
And Justice for All. I've seen A Few Good Men, Witness for the Prosecution, which one would you remake? A Few Good Men.
And who would you cast as Tom Cruise's character and Jack Nicholson's character?
Jack Nicholson... Either my father or Mr. Bachchan. And Tom Cruise, Shah Rukh Khan.
That'd be great, yeah.
And there's also Demi Moore.
Demi.
Alia Bhatt.
What's the obsession with Alia Bhatt? I'm getting really worried about that. We should have a word offline.
Yeah, it's
too much?
Too good. Yeah.
And this is the big question now before we wrap up. So, Kayoze, now, obviously, flush with success and well done. All very proud of you. And it's called Ajeeb's Dastans. And you have to watch it. Silvery, you'll watch it now. Your mom is going to make sure you watch it after that abuse that you did. But what about Shadi? Now, I just did the maths into your 30s now. So, are we going to get a Mrs. Irani?
Is there anyone you have in mind?
Well, I was thinking Alia, but then that didn't work out. So. Would you marry from the fraternity?
I'm ready to marry anybody. Why not? But I have to. Why don't you?
Aisha's got a lovely girl. Who's this? Arnaz. She'll manage your finances. A CA and lawyer. Lives in Hyderabad. Very pretty. I won't give the surname and all that because I don't want trouble. But okay. Pretty as well. I'll just check. Age. Appropriate, whatever that means. That's Aisha's appropriate. And she's slightly, you know, sexist towards the female. So,
I'm ready to get married, but no one else is marrying inside.
No, we're checking. We're doing this. Okay, Rishra will happen live. We've taken a vow now.
Aisha's playing Cupid.
And she's a Parsi girl, so there shouldn't be any problem also.
Yeah, the family's happy. They don't mind.
And the father's very keen that she marries a prominent Parsi, which you are.
Whose father?
Arnaz's father.
Arnaz's father is keen to marry a Parsi. My father is like, okay, marry anyone you want.
Yeah, he's looking low-hanging fruit now. He doesn't care. He's just worried that no one will marry you. So as long as it's female of any kind, of any age, organs.
That's why I made a love story. That people will say, oh, he's sensitive. Nice. You know, that's the reason I made it.
That's a horrible thing to do because then not only will they marry you, they won't leave you. So always keep your options open is what I say. This is my advice. Yeah. And by the way, as you get married, then the last of the Mohicans will be that poor friend of yours, Kunal. So you make sure you find someone for him. And if not a woman, then at least a plant or something. He needs some companionship.
Kunal's very happy. Kunal's my buddy. Kunal's my...
I don't think Kayoze, he can get married now. At age 57 in May, he's too set in his ways. It won't happen. Never be careful.
Never say never. Maybe.
On your early 30s, there's still hope. Boss, as every year passes, Silvery, this is for you too. If you want to get married, there's a cutoff. You can't just marry at any time. Silvery's frozen.
No, he's here.
Okay. All right. Kayoze. Okay, let's squeeze one more. It's only 10:54.
Sure. He says, comes in from G. Says, hi, Kayoze. Love the last two stories in Ajeeb Dastans, including yours. If I had to nitpick, though, how would you justify the sudden turn of character in the main protagonist towards the end?
I wouldn't justify it. because I think that her character, Natasha's character, and I know that you all won't know what I'm talking about because you're not seeing the film, but her character, that is the choice that she made. That doesn't mean that that is the correct choice to make.
Very good answer.
But it is her decision as a person, because that's the thing about today, is that just because something is correct doesn't mean that that's the decision you think is right for yourself. So she decided to choose that way, and she put her daughter above herself. So I don't justify it at all. I would have been done something different. But I felt that her character, that was the choice he made. It was a hard choice, and it was a heartbreaking choice.
The story is completely by you, Kayozi?
No, just the idea is mine.
Okay, so but fleshed out by others, but it's your story.
The screenplay is written by Sumit Saxena and Uzma Khan.
That's a language issue more than anything else. So you basically have written it, and then they've sort of...
No. Genuinely. I just knew the first scene of the film. I knew the last scene of the film. And they wrote everything else.
Okay.
But we would sit together and we'd work, and they would... I would give ideas, and they'd say, oh, this is a rubbish idea. And I said, oh, I agree with you. And then they'd write a better idea. So...
Now, whose idea was this?
Which one?
The ending where the woman puts her daughter above everything else?
That I Raju Hirani told me, don't even think of making a film unless you know your first scene and your last scene. So that I knew in my head what it had to be. It had to be this, that she takes this choice that doesn't mean that it's the right choice.
Is it possible to make a film where your first scene is your last scene?
So
question was from Kunal Vijaykar. I just saw it.
They do that in some movies, like in Gone Girl. The first scene is very similar to the last scene, like the way it's shot.
No, I don't think that's what Cyrus meant, though. I think Cyrus just said that people don't have patience anymore, and now they want to watch short films. So now Cyrus is taking it one step further and making it one scene.
But even the movies I watch, I always check the time. I've always checked the time now. Versus like when I eat, I always check the price. These two things are very clear with me for some reason. I don't know, maybe it's just...
Yeah, probably, I always check the time.
I always look right side of the menu. I always look right side and then look left side. So I don't feel bad. If I see 60 rupees, then I look happy. If I see 160 rupees, I don't even look there. I always stay in this zone. See how much advice we give on this show, free advice, which makes sense. All right, Kayozi, that's it. Anything else, young man, Silvery?
No, I'll go.
Okay. All the best. Are you going to tell us as you say bye what's happening next, or is that not a fair question to ask a creative person?
I would love to answer that question, but I don't know. I promise. Wait. I don't know.
So now you want to wash everything out of your system for some time and then restart again?
No. I mean, we are in the process of trying to figure something out, but nothing's concrete yet. Okay. Just a little writing and whatnot. But if I knew, I would be happiest to announce it on your show.
I can get you a very cheap actor in his early 20s with a beard. So you just tell me he's available.
Okay.
Silvery, what are the rates? We'll work them out, no?
Yeah. Not a problem.
I don't think Kunal's in his early 20s, but okay.
No, I'm talking, I've given up on Kunal. Kunal is now museum. We have to put him in a museum and people have to come and watch, and because his movements are also even less mobile. We are working on Silvery's career. There's hope there.
Okay.
All right. See you, Kayozi. Lovely talking to you.
Thank you so much.
Ajib Dastans. It's called Unkahi.
Correct.
Google it. It's a word apparently in Persian. We'll find out. All right. That is the story of Kayozi, now to be made into song. Kayozi. Kayozi, Kayozi, my love. Say bye.
Bye.
Okay, catch us on any of the podcasting apps, please. We beg you, we need you. Send us your questions on Twitter, on Cyrus Says In. Or you can email us, even if you're not female, on whatcyrussays@gmail.com.
Come learn and experience the ABCDs of being queer with me, Shunetro.
And me, Farhad.
On our show, Gay BCD.
The two of us take you through our stories and experiences of being gay men in the city of Mumbai and have candid
and sometimes downright scandalous
conversations about sexuality, gay culture, and everything in between.
Catch new episodes of Gay BCD every Tuesday on the IVM Podcast website, app, or wherever you get all your podcasts from.
If you love cricket, listen up. The Edges and Sledges Cricket Podcast is here for you. Hosted by DJ, Varun, and me, Ashwin, we bring a fun, fresh, fans' point of view to talking all things cricket. Sometimes it's just the three of us, sometimes we have guests, including current and former international cricketers. For new episodes every week, check out the Edges and Sledges Cricket Podcast on the IVM app, website, or wherever you get your podcasts.